Morning students, in my previous video I have discussed about early computing devices. Now in this video I will discuss about generation of computers. Generation in computer terminology is a change in technology. A computer is or was being used. Initially the generation term was used to distinguish between varying hardware technologies. Nowadays, generation includes both hardware and software, which together make up an entire computer system. There are five computer generation known till date. Each generation will discuss in detail along with their time period and characteristics. First generation computer. The first computer system used vacuum tubes for circuitry and magnetic drums for memory and were often enormous, taking up entire rooms. These computers were very expensive to operate, and in addition to using a great deal of electricity, the first computer generated a lot of heat, which was often the cause of malfunctions. First generation computers relied on machine language, the lowest level programming language understood by computers, to perform operations, and they could only solve one problem at a time. It would take operators days or even week to set up a new problem. Input was based on punch card and paper tape, and output was displayed on printouts. The UNIVAC and ENIAC computers are examples of first generation computing devices. Features of first generation computers: used vacuum tubes, huge computer that occupied lot of space, high electricity consumption, unreliable, frequent hardware failures, commercial production was difficult, very costly and required constant maintenance, continuous air conditioning was required. Programming was done in machine language, although assembly language also started at the end of this generation. Second generation computer. The word would see transistors replace vacuum tubes in the second generation of computers. The transistor was invented at Bell Labs in 1947 but did not see widespread use in computers until the late 1950s. The transistor was far superior to the vacuum tube, allowing computers to become smaller, faster, cheaper, more energy efficient, and more reliable than their first generation predecessor. Though the transistor still generated a great deal of heat that subjected the computer to damage, it was a vast improvement over the vacuum tube. Second generation computer still relied on punch cards for input and printouts for outputs. Second generation computers move from cryptic binary machine language to symbolic or assembly languages, which allowed programmers to specify instructions in words. High level programming languages were also being developed at this time, such as early versions of COBOL and Fortran. These were also the first computers that stored their instructions in their memory, which moved from a magnetic drum to magnetic core technology. The first computers of this generation were developed for the atomic energy industry. Example of second generation computer, IBM 1401 and IBM 1620. Features of second generation computers: transistor based technology were smaller and less expensive as compared to first generation computers, consume less electricity, less heat. Magnetic core memories and magnetic disks were used as primary and secondary storage respectively. First operating system developed, programming in assembly language, and in the latter part high level languages were used. Wider commercial use, but commercial production was still difficult. They also required constant air conditioning. Third generation computer. The development of the integrated circuit was the hallmark of the third generation of computers. Transistors were miniaturized and placed on silicon chips called semiconductors, which drastically increased the speed and efficiency of computers. Instead of punch cards and printouts, users interacted with third generation computers through keyboards and monitors and interfaced with an operating system, which allowed the device to run many different applications at one time with a central program that monitored the memory. Computers for the first time became accessible to a mass audience because they were smaller and cheaper than their predecessors. Now we will see features of third generation computers. Use the integrated circuits were smaller, faster and more reliable. Low power consumption and less emission of heat as compared to previous generations. Example, IBM 360 series, Honeywell 6000 series. Fourth generation computer. The microprocessor used in the fourth generation of computers as thousands of integrated circuits were built onto a single silicon chip. What in the first generation filled an entire room could now fit in the palm of the hand. The Intel 4004 chip developed in 1971 located all the components of the computer from the central processing unit and memory to input or output controls on a single chip. In 1981, IBM introduced its first computer for the home user, and in 1984, Apple introduced the Macintosh. Microprocessors also moved out of the realm of desktop computers and into many areas of life as more and more everyday products began to use microprocessors. As these small computers became more powerful, they could be linked together to form networks, which eventually led to the development of the internet. Fourth generation computers also saw the development of GUIs, the mouse and handheld devices. features of fourth generation computers. ICs with LSI and VLSI technology, microprocessors developed, portable computers developed, networking and data communication became popular. Types of secondary memory with high storage capacity and fast access developed, very reliable, powerful and small in size, negligible power consumption and heat generation, very less production cost. Now we will talk about fifth generation computers. Fifth generation computing devices based on artificial intelligence are still in development, though there are some applications such as voice recognition that are being used today. The use of parallel processing and superconductors is helping to make artificial intelligence a reality. Quantum computation and molecular and nanotechnology will radically change the face of computers in years to come. The goal of fifth generation computing is to develop devices that respond to natural language input and are capable of learning and self-organization. Features of fifth generation computers: parallel processing, superconductivity, and artificial intelligence.